now he turns 31 and he again finds himself out of the test team. So how do you look at his test career panning out in the next few years?
I think UV has always been a soft target as far as test cricket is concerned. He was playing at the time when Sachin Tendulkar, Dravid, Lakshman and Ganguly occupied the middle order. As and when one of them was unfit, he would come in, whether score or not score, go back. This went on in 2010 in Sri Lanka. He was down with dengue, so he missed the second test match, though he had scored the first test match, some 60, 62. Then that test match, Rayna played 100 on debut. Ideally, when he was fit, he should have come back. But Rayna was continued. So these are the factors. Look, this is a game where these things will happen. This is team sport. But I feel very sorry. I was at Calcutta, and he batted very well for those 32. He batted very well for 74 at Ahmedabad. But that you get out when you are doing well. It happens. And then suddenly, if I don't want you, then you say, oh, he scored only 74, he scored only 32. But how did he score? In which situation he scored? That, you know, when team loses, few heads roll. I think his head was always the first one to roll, whether he did it right or not. And this has been a curse in Indian cricket.
So is it a curse that he has been labelled as a one-day player primarily?
Who labels one-day players? We label. Zahir Khan, he has no business to be in T20. How did he manage to be in T20? It is that, you know, we label. The thing is, we feel. Look at that knock of 169 that he played against Pakistan at Bangalore. I was that knock.
India were 4 down under 100.
Beautiful drives. Mohammad Sami and all those. Nobody, you know, he was bisecting the field at will. And here is a boy where you would have said, okay, you're going to be next 10 test, come what may, you're going to be playing next 5 test matches. Don't bother about it. If every test match there is a, you know, okay, you don't score, you'll be dropped. Then you cannot expect stroke players to be a stroke player.
So, now lastly, Yuvraj has always performed in the big tournaments, be it the World Cup, ICC World T20, the NatWest Series Final, for example. So, there is something about him, about the big tournaments, that brings the best out of him. You said that he likes that challenge.
That's what I said.
So, isn't this a challenge for him, a new challenge to get back into the test team again?
He'll get back. He'll get back. But sooner than later, Sachin will be out. Sehwag will be out. All he has to do is, he has to, and he should resolve that, look, come what may, every time I take a leg stump guard, I'm going to spend 2 sessions over there on the field. He has to bat, he has to learn to bat for minimum 3 hours. If that habit he forms, he can come back to test cricket. It was very difficult for him to dislodge all those 4 superstars. But now, 3 have gone. Dravid, Lakshman and Ganguly. 1 will go. So now, he has got chance because he's been the most experienced person. He's been playing international cricket for 12 years now.